Welcome to another edition of Back Porch Cigar Reviews. Here doing the Alec Bradley Filthy Hooligan, the Barber Pole cigar. Dan, why don't you give us some info on this cigar here?
It's the Black Market Filthy Hooligan by Alec Bradley. Like John said, it's a barber pole wrapper. It's a combination of a Candela wrapper from Honduras and a Jalapa wrapper from Nicaragua. It's an Ecuadorian Sumatra binder. The fillers are Panamanian and Honduran. It's a 6x52 stick, medium body. The cost is about $8.50.
It's a beautiful little cigar. Looks like it's a double cap. Of course, it's a barber pole. The label seems to match the cigar itself, which is pretty cool. Got the little Candela tip. And looks like it's packed pretty good too. It's got a nice draw, nutty aroma. Grassy notes.
Does have a good draw.
It's got that Candela wrapper, which I'm sure is going to sweeten this up a little bit. We did a review on Drew Estate's Kentucky Fire Cure with the Candela wrapper. Would really smooth that cigar out. So.
Yes, it did. Yeah.
Got a nice aroma.
Slight hit of pepper.
Very light. Definitely sweet grass from the Candela.
I think it's a black pepper on the retro here. Not real strong.
Yeah. Other than that, really too much distinctive flavor.
Yeah, nothing jumped out at you right away. It is grassy, almost like a sweet grass.
All right, at the first third, I'm getting a little bit of a wavy burn here. Still great draw. I guess on the short finish of grassiness, sweetness, sweet grassiness, followed up by slight coffee and I guess a black pepper.
Definitely a mild black pepper, like a wet grassiness. It's making plenty of smoke, and there's a slight creaminess in the background. Leaves a little bit of a sweet aftertaste.
Still get mostly grass. I guess the only change in flavor is more like a hay. It's really creamy. And then on the back of the tongue, I'm getting a slight, you're saying wood, but I'm getting like a coffee, a slight bit of coffee.
It's definitely, I'm getting wood out of it. Can't really describe what kind of wood.
Yeah, well, you better be careful taking that first band off because it matches perfectly with the cigar.
Yes, it did.
I'm getting a paper taste. Almost like a cigar wrapper.
You're still getting plenty of smoke out of it.
Yeah, I mean, it's, I think it's more on the medium side, or mild.
Mild, yeah, mild to medium.
Mild to medium. And this would go, yeah, I think even a beginner might be able to try this cigar.
Yep, and I'm definitely a morning cigar.
And it is the morning.
Yes, it is.
We should have our coffee, but this be a great cigar with a coffee. It's really enjoyable smoke.
It's transitioning slightly to a more woody taste. That wet, sweet grass is still there. The peppers died down quite a bit, still there on the retrohale. Maybe a little bit on the back of the tongue. It's been a really pleasant cigar. I would recommend this for a beginning smoker or for a morning smoke. I'd have to rate this like 3.75.
The burn's been great throughout the whole cigar. Draw's been great. I don't think there's any really much change in taste, you know, complexity of it. Hay, grassiness. Slightly on the back of the tongue, slight bit of coffee. The strength did pick up a lot more in the final third.
Yes, it did.
And more of a medium cigar. I'm probably going to get a 3.5 for it. Good smoke. Great morning cigar. Enjoyed it a lot. So, we'll catch you next time on Back Porch Cigar Reviews.
Yeah, got the
still there on the retrohale, but much less tobacco.
Slight.
Go ahead. Go right ahead.
Yeah.
Which one's your main?
Dad, don't let me interrupt you.
The audio's in that one, Dad.
It's recording. Just walked in front of it.
That's all right.
I'm not going to use that.
All right.
Let's. We'll cut that out.
Yeah. All right. Let's.